Hello out there. This is another quick tip from the team at BlenderTek.com. That's BlenderTek.com. Today I'm going to quickly show you how to use your graphics card as a device to compute renders in Blender. I own an AMD video card. My laptop I bought a few years ago actually as a gaming laptop when AMD had just released the A series of CPUs, which included a video core chip on the CPU die. So that way your CPU had essentially an integrated video card, which was a step above just plain integrated graphics. As well, my laptop has a dedicated graphics card. However, I am not able to use that to do any kind of rendering in the current and even the latest beta versions of Blender. I have to use my CPU. And so, for example, last night I just did a simple 3-second render of an animation and it took well over 5 hours. It wasn't too complicated of a scene, but just each frame was taking about 5 minutes, which is ridiculous. So what I did is I searched around and I found a little bit of information. You can see here, this is the original render time with my CPU in a test scene I set up. It took 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Once I enabled the settings so that I could use my graphics card and all my integrated stuff, it went down to 2 minutes and 54 seconds with my CPU, GPU, and what they call Turks and Devastators add-ons. When I removed the Turks and Devastators add-ons, it actually went down to 2 minutes and 48 seconds. So there's a little bit of variation in there, and this wasn't a completely fair trial because I had antivirus scan running in the background and I also had Firefox open. But either way, I did a few tests and I achieved anywhere from 2 or 3% up to a 20% decrease in render times. Over a long period of rendering, if you're doing images or large scenes, that can add up to huge time savings. So let me show you how to do that. Go to start and press run, or you can just press Windows key and R, then type in CMD. This will bring up a command prompt. You're going to navigate to where Blender is installed. By default, that is here. Navigate to Program Files, then navigate to Blender Foundation, because that's where Blender is usually installed, and then navigate into the folder Blender. This is where Blender.exe is stored. And then we're going to type in a simple command. It's going to set environment variable. If you don't know what that is, do a quick Google search. We're going to go set, and then in all caps, we're going to do cycles. So this is using the cycles rendering engine. I'm not sure what would happen if you use the Blender internal rendering engine. Excuse me, it's flu and cold season here in Canada. Followed by an underscore, OpenCL, that's not OpenGL, that's OpenCL. Another underscore, test. So I believe that this is still in the testing and beta stages. And then equals all. This may look like a dash on your screen. That's a mistake I made at first, but it's actually test equals all. Then hit enter, and because we have no errors, now start Blender your usual way. You can do something like a slash dot or dot slash Blender or Blender.exe, but I'm just simply going to type start Blender.exe. From there, go to File, User Preferences, or the Control hotkey, Control Alt U, go to System, and by default, if you don't have an NVIDIA graphics card, or it just isn't compatible, you'll only be able to select your CPU as the computing device. But now, it's added on a new tab called OpenCL. From here, we have 4 options. Depending on what your system has, you may have more or less options. I have Devastator, I have Turks. I don't know what those two are. I'm going to have to do some more research into that. But I can choose to use my AMD A10 APU with a video card core on the CPU die with Radeon HD graphics. So that's the built-in integrated graphics on my motherboard. This still doesn't allow me to use my full graphics card, but it allows me to use the graphics core that is built into my CPU. And while it's not as powerful as a full dedicated graphics card, it is definitely a step up from integrated graphics. And here you can see that it's using both. So I'm using integrated graphics plus my CPU, plus my CPU's video card core. And then you can also select all 4. And again, like I said, a little bit of variation between the two. I'm going to leave it selected as all four. That just seems to me that that would be the most efficient, and then hit save user settings. From here, you just render a test scene and see how long it takes. Go back and change the settings to back to CPU, change it to different settings, play around with it, do different scenes, do complicated scenes, do simple scenes, and save all of your renders in one folder and organize them by name. Call one CPU scene one, call one GPU scene one, call one OpenCL plus Devastator plus Turks scene one, and there you'll be able to find out what is the fastest way to render a scene in Blender. This should save you a ton of time in rendering, which can end up being almost as much as modeling in some instances, especially when you're doing test scenes like this. So again, this is just a quick tip from the team here at BlenderTek.com. That's BlenderTek.com. If you like this video and it was helpful, please leave a comment. If you're having trouble with any of the steps in here, please leave a comment and I will reply to you as fast as possible, or I'm sure someone else will. If I come up with any new information, I'll post a new video and I'll link to it as an annotation. If you dislike this video for some reason, please leave a comment why, and I will be able to improve my videos based on your input in the future. Just hitting the dislike button does nobody any good. That is called criticism. Again, thanks again from BlenderTek.com. Remember, create your way.